And over to Africa, where leaders met yesterday to launch a continental free trade zone that, if successful, would unite 1.3 billion people and create a $3.4 trillion economic bloc and usher in a new era of development. After 4 years of talks, an agreement to form a 55-nation trade bloc was reached in March, paving the way for Sunday's African Union summit in Niger, where attendees unveiled which nation will host trade zone's headquarters, when trading will start, and discussed how exactly it will work. It is hoped that African Continental Free Trade Area, or AFCA, largest since creation of World Trade Organization in 1994, will help unlock Africa's long problematic economic potential by boosting intra-regional trade, strengthening supply chains, and spreading expertise. Africa has much catching up to do. Its intra-regional trade accounted for just 17% of exports in 2017 versus 59% in Asia and 69% in Europe. And Africa has missed out on economic boom that other trade blocs have experienced in recent decades. Now, economists say significant challenges remain, including poor road and rail links, large areas of unrest, excessive border bureaucracy and petty corruption that have held back growth and integration. IMF, in a May report, described a free trade zone as a potential economic game changer of the kind that has boosted growth in Europe and North America. But it added a note of caution as well.